हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट आवर हाउ द प्लांट्स आर यूजफुल फॉर अस, मीन्स हाउ प्लांट्स वी आर गेटिंग डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फूड्स, मेडिसिन एंड अदर प्रोडक्ट ऑल्सो फ्रॉम द प्लांट। सो प्लांट ऑल्सो गिविंग द ऑक्सीजन टू अस, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू आवर लाइफ। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट वी हैव स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस चैप्टर, दैट इज प्लांट। Students, today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is also how the animals are helpful for us. Okay, exactly how plants are helping to us, or plants are very important to our lives. So like this, how animals are very important for us, today we are going to study. So also we have studied plants are different types, means it small plant is there, big plants also are there. So you can see different kinds of plants in our environment. So like this students, animals also are different, animals are also there. And we have also studied plants are in grow in a different places, yes or no? So plants will grow different places, means it may be desert area, it may be mountain area, it may be other places. Like this students, animals we can found in different places. Okay, so let's start today how. So before going to start about how animals are helpful for us, today we are just introduced about what are the know about some fact about the animals. Okay, after that we will start our next how animals are helping to our day to day life. So let's know about the some fact about animals. So let's start students. So this is the chapter 3, animals that help us. Just before going to know about the how animal is helping to our life, day to day life, before going to discuss about this, we will know the some fact about the animals. Okay students, we know if you will see outside, we will see the different kinds of plants. So exactly animals also, different types of animals are in our environment are there. So things like plants and us, animals are also living things. First of all, like plants and us, animals are also living things. Students, we know we are the living things and plants also living things. We can move one place to another place, we can eat, we can grow. So we are living things. Exactly our animals also living things like plants and us. See student here, like plants and us, animals are also living things. So there are different types of animals are there. You know also some examples: cat, lion, tiger, cow, lion and elephants and some other animals also are there in our environment. Dog. So these are the different kinds of animals I will show you. See students, this is the wild animals. Just you know these are the animals. In front of you you see lion, tiger, leopard, cheetah, panther, lemur and rhinoceros, puma, deer, fox, elephant, wolf, koala, giraffe. So these are the different types of animals you can find in your environment. Yes or no? Just now I said like yours, plant animals also, they are living. They can move, they can eat, they can grow day to day life. Okay? After also they can die also. So these are also living things. Like plants also, students, animals also are different from each other. Okay? When you look at outside, you will observe different kinds of plants are there, from small to big. All plants are not same. I told you in previous chapter also. So like this students, animals also, when you will observe animals, when you will see outside the different types of animals, they are also different from each other. All the animals are not same. Okay? How human beings means how we are also different from each other, and plants are different from each other. Like this also, animals are different from each other. You see, are all the animals here are looking same? No. All are looks like different from each other. See, lions, compare with lion and tiger, and panther, puma, monkey, kangaroo, fox, giraffe, elephant. So these all the plants, sorry, all the animals are different from each other according to their color also, according to their body, according to their other things. They are different from each other. Understood, students? So next, like plants and animals, also and other animals, I can show you. See, this is the sea animals. Okay, amphibians and reptiles. This is the, you see, all these are the also are comes under animals. See, fish and dolphins. You might not know. This is the chameleon, frog. So these snakes. Crocodile. So these are also, this is called tortoise or turtle. So these also are comes under animals. Look at here, students. You can find these are not same. Okay, these all are animals are different from each other. See, these all are different from one each other. See, snakes. It is one type of snakes. It is one type of crocodile, it is also alligator, it is one type of turtle. So these all are different from each other animals, like exactly like human beings and plants. How all the human beings and plants are different from each other, like this animals also different from each other. Understood? See, students, these are the birds also. See, these all birds you might have seen here, all are different from each other. Look at here, crow, rooster, turkey, kingfisher, so different types of pigeons, goat. So these all the types of birds are different from each other. Look at here one by one. See, compare with the dove and pigeon. Dove is a white, but pigeon is a another in color. So these all the animals also are different from each other. So it is saw that how the all the plants and human beings are different from each other. Plants, sorry, animals also they are different from each other. Understood, students? Like plants, animals are also found in different places. And I told you in previous classes, we can see the plants in different places. Not only in our home campus, or not only in the park, not only in the other garden, you can see plants in everywhere in our around. Like the students, you can see the different types of animals in our environment in different places. You might have seen, you might have experienced that. You might have seen in different types of places dogs, cat, horse, camel. Sometimes you will come to your village, towns also, elephant also. So like the students, like plants, animals are also found in different places. Understood, students? So these all things you have to write down in your class or notebook. When I am explaining, you have to write down. Okay, students? Some animals grow in personalized environment called farm. It's very important. See, students, some animals grow in personalized environment called farm. Okay? You might have heard that words, that is farm. You might have seen also different types of animals. They will be taken care by some people. So this type of is called personalized. Okay? Some people, they will take care or they will grow their one type of kind of animals in their homes. That is called personalized environment. That is called farm. Okay? Farm. Some animals grow in personalized environment called farm. So that process is called farm. Once again, I repeat, some animals grow in personalized environment. Personalized means some one some type of people, some people they will grow their animals, one kind of or two kind of animals in their homes. Okay, they will make a home and they will grow their different types of one, two, three types of animals in their home is called, that is called personalized environment called farm. Okay, the animals, see students, here you can see it is a home in the picture. That home, one birds is there, or some people so will make a home and in the inside that home they will keep different types of one types of birds or one types of animals like cow or horse. They will grow in that home, that is called farm. Okay, that animals which we tame are called domestic animal. Okay, one second, the animals which we tame are called domestic animal. That animal which we will keep in a home and we will grow them and they will take care of them, so that animal is called domestic animals. Okay, which animal, shortly I will tell you which animal we will keep in our home and we will take care of them, that is called domestic animal. Home means we will make a home for them, we will construct a home for them and we will take care day to day life for them, so we will grow them. So that type of animals is called domestic animals. Okay students, look at this picture, you can see it is a home. Okay, in that home, inside that home, one part is there. Like these students, you might have seen different types of home are there. They will keep the horses, cow, buffalo, they will keep and they will grow them and they will take care of them. So this is called domestic animals. Some domestic animals, example like cow, you know that elephant, horse and different birds also, and we can say buffalo also. So these are the animals are comes under domestic animal, which we will keep in a separate home and we will take care of them day to day life. So this type of home, this type of animals is called domestic animals. And students, once again I repeat, you see, like plants and us, animals are also living things. Okay, like us and plants, animals also living things. For example, cat, rat, tiger, cow, lion, elephant, they are also living things. Whatever I saw through picture, these all animals are living things because they can move one place to another thing, another place, another thing. They can grow, they can die also. Okay, they need food, water, and light to grow also. So these are living things. Second, they also look different from each other. Just before I showed you chart, how the animals are different from each other. It may be animals, tiger, lion, cat. It may be birds, different type pigeons, dog. It may be fish, different fish, or crocodile, or alligator. So these all are animals are from different from each other. So like plants, animals are also found in different places. Okay, like plants, animals are also found in different places. You know, when you look at outside, you will see the different kinds of plants everywhere. Like this, when you go through the environment, when you go to outside, you will see the different kinds of animals also. When you go forest, when you go in other places, you will see the different kinds of animals. Like for example, in your village or in your town city, you will see sometimes different dogs, cat, rabbit and rat. So these are called some animals. Like plants, animals are also found in different places. Okay, next, some animals grow in their personalized environment called farm. Okay, for some animals growing personalized means separate environment. Okay, personalized means I can say separate environment called farm. The animals which we tame are called domestic animal, are called domestic animal. It is very important. See, the animals which we tame are called domestic animal. The animals which we tame means we will take care of them day to day life. You might have seen cow, buffalo and horses, we will take care elephants, we will take care of them, we will keep in near to our home, we will make a separate home for them. Okay? So these type of animals are called domestic animals. Okay? So for example, cow, elephant, horse and different birds, buffalo, also they are concerned of domestic animals because these animals, people will keep them in separate home, near it to their home, and they will take care of them. Okay? So these are called domestic animals. See students, here one figure is given. This figure is tiger and this figure is rabbit. How they are animals? They are concerned under animals, but they are different from each other. It is very big, it is very small. And their color, according to their color also, they are different each other. Understood students? So this is all about the know about the animals. Okay? So but our main things was animals that help us. Okay? That how animals are help us, what are the things we are getting, foods and other products we are getting from the animals. Next class we will start student. Okay? So this is all about today's know about the animals. So students, I hope all of you understood properly and write down all the things. When you will watch the video, you write down all the things and then watch the video 2-3 times, then you will get a new idea, okay, about the animals. So thank you students. Next class we will start our how animals are helpful for us or how animals is helping to our day to day life. Okay students, so thank you very much, take care.